US Marines conduct another patrol through the Garmshire district of South Helmand. It is quiet and they meet no resistance. This area, however, has not always been so benign. When the Marines first pushed into Garmshire with the task of clearing out the substantial Taliban presence there, they were met with resistance and several days of hard fighting followed. Many Marines here are young, and for most of them, it is their first time on an operational deployment. I was curious to see how they prepared for combat, what they thought during it, and how they dealt with it afterwards.
I mean, the Marine Corps does a pretty good job of doing it. Like, take you for about a year, just put you through a lot of training, to where, like, you know, when stuff does start happening, like bullets and stuff, you don't really, it's more automatic, all your reactions, it's not really, I mean, you kind of, like, lose all emotions and stuff, you just get after it.
I was just kind of thinking, like, what I had to do, where I had to position my guys, stuff like that. You know, it's not just me, I'm a team leader, so I have to worry about them too.
We try and get our hands on as much intelligence about the enemy as possible and try and think through every which way that the enemy could affect us in our attacks.
Basically, just try to build, like, good relations within the squad, so, because that's all I'm going to have when I get over there, once we get into a fight or something, so basically I got to build up relationships with them so we can trust each other.
As a squad leader, you know, you have to be the father figure slash, you know, mission leader. You know, it's a fine balance, you know, and you can't really let them see any fear at all, because it, you know, it's infectious. Then your guys will start being afraid, et cetera, et cetera. So I pretty much just put on the game face, you know. I've become, you know, the man of stone, so to speak. You know, you just put everything out, and usually they follow suit, you know, and they put their game face on and get busy with everything, and, you know, it usually comes out all right.
Once the bullets started flying, the margin for error became very thin, and the Marines were required to put all their training to use.
We talk about this a lot, actually. I think at this time, your brain is pretty much immune. You're numb. You're numb to it. You're told to do something, and you're just like, all right, let's do it. Like, if we were told to walk 20 miles tonight, everybody would complain about it and whine, but we'd do it.
Stop those bullets from coming my way. The best way to do that is to send some back.
A lot of things go through your head, you know. Just you're hoping your buddies are all right who are away from the battlefield from where you are. They're off in a different area fighting. You're hoping that they're okay. You're hoping that, you know, really you're just hoping that you're not going to get shot. You're just moving forward, trying to get the mission done and keep your guys safe.
During combat, the Marines drew great strength from the person next to them.
It's exciting to have them there. You know, they got your back and you got their back. Just got to watch over each other. I guess that's what keeps you going, mainly making sure everybody else stays safe.
Oh, it's a tremendous, tremendous, you know, help having your buddies with you, because they're the guys who pick you up and help you out, because everybody has their tough times at different times throughout the crisis. So when you're having a tough time, you can lean on your buddy. And when he's having a tough time, he can lean on you. And these guys are great. We lean on each other all the time. You know, they're awesome, awesome. I wouldn't want to do this with anybody else.
After a few days, the fighting had ended and the Taliban had been removed from Garmshire. The Marines had succeeded and the younger, newer Marines had proved themselves.
And how do you think your men performed in combat? Were you proud of them in the job that they did?
Oh, yeah.
Bearing on a lot of them the first time?
In all aspects, even the new guys, you know, the ones that have never seen, you know, any kind of violence or anything, they did real good. They did their job. They didn't feel sorry about anything. Just carried out the mission, you know, as best they could.
You know, I was really privileged to be, you know, working with such, you know, talented Marines, who knew their jobs and did their jobs well. It made this, you know, very successful.
While the combat is over and peace is beginning to return to the Garmshire area, the Marines must remain vigilant and prepared in providing security for the district. This is Josh Fortune for the NATO channel, Garmshire, South Helmand.